AI structure is called a graph. Graph is organized item in the interconnected network. So edge of graph, you can see the node, which is called sometimes the vertex, and node are connected by the edge. So this is the node and this is the edge. So strengths, representing links. So if you see, the graphs are ideal cases when you are working with the things that connect to each other, right? Nodes and edge could be, for example, of representing of the cities and highway and Ethernet cables and Facebook users and the friendship. And weakness for a graph is a scaling challenge. The most of graph algorithm are order of n log n into log of n, or even slower. Depending on the size of your graph and running algorithm across your nodes may not be feasible, right? And so before going to the deep, so let's go some terminology. Direct and undirected graph, right? So when you have a direction of the each nodes, and this is called a directed graph. When you don't have the graph direction, right? So edge point from one node at one and other nodes other ends. So in the undirected graph, the edge are simply connected and nodes each end. So cyclics, right? When the nodes is cyclic, has a cycle, right? Unbroken series. If the series no repeating nodes on edge, the connected back itself. Graph without cycle is acyclic. Weighted and unweighted. So this is the weighted graph, right? So if graph is weighted, each edge has a weight, and this weight could be example of representing distance between two location, or cost, or time it has traveled between the location. Legal coloring, the graph coloring. When you assign color each nodes in a graph, the legal coloring means no adjacent node have a same color. This is the perfect example, and this is the wrong example. Okay, so now let's go the representation of the graph, right? This is my graph 0 1 0 1 2 3. So so first is edge list. Okay, so representation is the first method is edge list. So if you go the 0, so what is the edge? Okay, he started from 1, so 1 0 and 1 1 and 2, this is the edge list, and 1 and 3 and 2 2 to 3. So since node 3 has an edge called node 3 has an edge node 1 and node 2, right? So 1 1 to 3 and 2 to 3, right? So adjacency list, in where the index represent the nodes and the value of the index of list in the neighbors, right? So if you see the 0, right? So 0 is what is the neighbor is 1, and for index 1, what is the neighbor? 0 2 3. So index 1 neighbor is 0 2 3, right? Similarly way, index 2 1 and 3, index 2 1 and 3. So this is the urgency list and this is the edge list, right? And so if you would like to represent in the dictionary or in the hash table, you would like index would be the key and the urgency neighbor would be the value. Okay, and similarly way, you can represent graph in the matrix, and the matrix you mean 0 and 1 indicated whether the nodes x connected to node y, and 0 means no, 1 means yes, right? So there are two popular algorithm for graph traversal, and most of interview question will they will ask from using these two algorithms. So you should aware of BFS and DFS, right? Okay, so lots of graph problem can be solved using the just these traversal. Is there path between two nodes is a undirected graph? Okay, so if you have a questions, is there path between two nodes is an undirected graph, run DFS and BFS from one node and see if there is, if you reach the other one, right? If you reach directly, I mean if you are, so okay, so the next one, what is the shortest path between two nodes in the undirected unweighted graph? The run BFS from one node and backtrack to the one you reach the second node. BFS always find BFS. So right, your shortest path, assuming the graph is undirected, unweighted, DFS not always find the shortest path. Okay, so this is the way you need to do. Can the undirected graph be colored with the two color? Can undirected graph be colored with the two colors? Run BFS, assign the color as the nodes are the visited about if every time you assign an odd color different from the one it was assigned earlier, right? Does undirected graph have a cycle? Run BAPS, keep track the number of times you are visited to each nodes. If you visited nodes twice, then you have a cycle, right? And there are the advanced algorithm which you would like to go. These are topological sorts, minimum spanning tree.